In order to output the game screen in Unity as well as many other game engines, the camera must be used. If you understand all the functions of the camera, you can apply various techniques necessary for the game. Efficient use of the camera also improves the performance of the game. Now let's learn about each function of the camera and various tips. Clear flags is an option that determines whether certain parts of the screen are cleared. When using more than one camera, you can set it to draw the screen projected by the other cameras. The default is skybox, and if no object is drawn in the scene, the set skybox is drawn on the screen. If you change the clear flags option to solid color, the set color is drawn in the empty space of the scene. If you select the depth only option, it will appear as if nothing is displayed in the blank space, but you can composite it with the screen captured by another camera. You can use this to create a variety of directing and tricks. If you select Don't Clear, the color and depth information of the corresponding camera will not be updated. Therefore, as you can see now, it overlaps with other camera screens. This option is also used when you want to express a special direction. A culling mask is an option that determines whether the camera renders a game object applied as a specific layer. The default is everything. Changing it to nothing will cause nothing to be drawn to the screen. The default layer for all game objects is default. So if you change the culling mask option to default, everything will be drawn. If you change the chair layer to UI, the camera will not render the chair. If you want to draw a game object set as a UI layer, simply select the UI layer in the culling mask option. Projection determines how the camera projects the scene. When orthographic is selected, the camera ignores perspective and draws the scene. This method is usually used for 2D games or top-down 3D games. The area to draw the scene can be adjusted through the size. The field of view axis allows the camera to determine the basis of the vertical or horizontal field of view. The number of viewing angles varies depending on which standard you use, so you can decide whether your project screen is vertical or horizontal. Narrowing the field of view not only narrows the screen, but also has the effect of looking closer to the subject. If you activate the physical camera option, you can apply the settings of the actual camera. The sensor type option has the advantage of being able to use the camera format used for video as it is. However, additional camera knowledge may be required to use this option effectively. It is recommended to use it after understanding the specifications of the camera you want to use. Clipping planes are the start and end settings for rendering through the camera. As this allows you to control the precision of the camera's depth information and the culling of objects, this feature affects the performance of your project. A great example of using this is to create a foggy background. Since it is difficult to see far away due to fog, the camera does not need to render unnecessarily far, and performance improvement can be expected. The viewport rectangle is an option that allows you to change the location and area where the scene will be drawn. This can be used to display various functions in the game. For example, you can create a screen for making a video call. Let's set the depth of the camera shooting Yui-chan higher than the main camera. W and H are the width and height at which the camera outputs the screen, respectively. You can change the position of the screen drawn through the camera by changing the X and Y values. As we saw earlier, the depth of the camera will be drawn later as the value is higher. Let's add another camera and then increase the depth value. If we increase the depth value to 2, the screen drawn through the newly created camera will be covered. If you change the depth value of this camera to the lowest value, it becomes invisible because of the main camera screen. A rendering pass is an option that toggles how the scene will be rendered through the camera. The description of each rendering pass method requires a very high level of knowledge, so I will keep it brief. Forward rendering is a traditional rendering method that has been used for a long time and is suitable for low-end devices. However, there are disadvantages in that light operation is slow and shadow processing is difficult. The advantage of deferred rendering is that you can use a lot of real-time lighting, and the quality of the shadows is also good. However, a high-performance device is required to use this rendering path. The legacy vertex light path allows light to react only to the object's vertices, resulting in very fast rendering, but it does not cast shadows. This rendering path is suitable for game projects that do not require real-time shadows. Legacy deferred does not have a limit on the number of lights like deferred rendering, but it does not show very good quality because it is a rendering method of Unity 5 or earlier. According to the official Unity documentation, it is recommended to use either the forward or deferred rendering path rather than using the legacy rendering path. Please determine the appropriate rendering path according to your current game project and required hardware performance. Target texture is a function that saves the scene drawn by the camera as a texture. As mentioned earlier, the camera can be used for a variety of purposes because it reads both color as well as depth information. A render texture is required to save the projected scene as a texture. Let's make a texture of the scene seen through camera sub 2, and make this screen appear on the TV. By applying the render texture to the target texture, the camera renders it as a square. The reason is that the size of the render texture is set to 256 by 256 pixels. If you increase the width to 512 pixels, you will see that the rendering ratio of the camera has changed to 2 to 1. As the pixel size of the render texture increases, the memory usage also increases, so please be careful. Now we will create a new material so that the scene from the camera can be rendered on the screen of the TV. It is confirmed that the scene projected by the camera is visible on the screen of the TV. Since the screen of the TV uses light, we will change the shader of the material to unlit. Occlusion culling is a feature that removes pixels when a game object is obscured by another game object. It is recommended that this function be turned on to improve performance in 3D games. HDR stands for High Dynamic Range, which expresses a wider range of colors and brightness than the standard dynamic range. There is no color loss in bright areas, and bloom and glow effects can also be applied. However, video RAM usage increases, and performance loss occurs accordingly. MSAA is an option for reducing aliasing in rendered images. This option is automatically adjusted in the graphics settings, so it is best to leave it as it is unless there is a significant performance penalty. Dynamic resolution is a feature that automatically reduces the resolution progressively as the frame rate of the game decreases. All desktop computers and mobile devices are supported, but in the case of Android, only the Vulkan renderer is supported. So you should check the specifications of the target device first before using it. The targeted display option is only supported on desktop computers with multiple monitors. Each camera can be assigned a display number so that it can be displayed independently on multiple monitors when the application is launched. That's all for today's video. Thank you. See you next time.